I got a few comments asking for a template or a tutorial on how I created my task management system. So today I want to show you in Notion exactly how to create a task management system that is just like mine. And be sure to stick around to the end of the video because I have a special gift that will be super helpful to all of you. All right, so let's start making this task management system together. I'm going to go through it step by step. Some parts I'll speed through and I won't talk over just so this video won't be super long, but anything confusing, I will try to talk it through with you guys. All right, so right off the bat, make sure this is in full width. It usually isn't by default, but since we're using databases and they're kind of wide, it's a good idea to use full width right here. And then I use callouts to separate each section. So we're gonna call this section brain dump. Choose database inline. Just adding some basic categories here. Then we wanted to choose a priority section. And the last thing will be the checkbox here, and let's call this captured. There we go. All right, and for this title, you could just call it brain dump again. And I usually just like hide the title. You can move them back if you do layout and then show database title right there, but that's fine. So let's do something like edit video. Let's call this YouTube right there. Say we need it done in a week, priority medium, and then captured. And the one important thing here is filter, go captured, and then capture is unchecked. So basically with this section right here, this is going to be an input that then will output according to what priority and the due date we selected. So we're gonna have a section that is high priority and then medium priority and then low priority. And then the last one will be actually be our done section just to see things that you've already accomplished. So it will be brain dump and then the three priorities and then the done section, but I'll walk you through how that looks. Alrighty, we're gonna create our high priority section first. So to do this, we need to create a linked view of the database. So all five of those databases that I was talking about are actually all one database with different filters. So to do this, let's go up to table, click copy link, and then let's paste down here and then click create linked view of database already. So those are actually the same database you can see, and they have the exact same filter. And I forgot to throw in a call out, so let me do that real quick. All right, so now we have to tweak this database a little bit to reflect the high priority task that we want to get done. First thing is capture is now gonna be checked. We're gonna add another filter. We're gonna do priority, and that priority has to be high for it to be here. And then we can actually hide this. So it won't get rid of it in the top section, I'll just hide it in the bottom section. And then what I also like to do is add another checkbox. We'll call this done. And we can put that over there, shorten that. And then when we have a high priority task, we'll go to our brain dump section, create thumbnail. We have to do that right away. And now that we've marked captured, we'll see that it leaves this list and goes on to this high priority list. And we can also remove this done, or not remove it, but just hide it over there. Because remember, this is a linked view of the same database. So things we do here are still going to affect this one, basically. But this is all we need for our high priority database. Okay, I lied. There's actually one more thing that you probably want to do, and it's going to be done is unchecked. That way, when we check this, I'll do it real quick, it disappears. And we can clear that, unmark that, and then mark that back as unchecked. So when we complete something, we'll click it here, and then it'll actually go to our done section. All right, now let's create our medium section. So I'll do the call out real quick, and I'll speed through some of this so you don't have to watch the same thing the whole time. But we are going to create the linked view, and it's easier if you do it from the one you just created. That way, some of the filters will already be there. The filters won't change across them, but everything else does change. So since we have these three filters here, let's copy this and then put it here. Create linked view of database, and then so now we have three different ones, and we're gonna have to change the filters. So priority is now going to be, what I do is medium and low for this one. All right, and for this section I like to use due dates, just so as a low priority item is approaching, and the due date is approaching, it actually will move itself on to this week's section. So I'll show you how to do that. It looks confusing, but I'm gonna put up three different advanced date filters. And so basically it will encompass everything that's due this week, the next week, and the week before. So it will range for a 3-week period, just so when we have a low priority task and we forget about it for a long time, but we need to get it done, it will move itself onto this week, and then it will basically stay there for 3 weeks essentially. And it's also super cool. So say for this edit video task right here, say it's July 28th or 29th, and you're like, okay, I really have to get this done now. You can actually just drag that up there, and then it becomes a high priority task. Or if you're like, no, I don't need to get that done, you can move it back and the priority will actually shift and it'll become a medium task, which is, I think, a super cool feature of Notion. All right, and then to add the due dates, you'll do filter due dates, and then this will pop up. You want to go to add to advanced filter, and then I'll fill this out real quick, but I'll speed it up for you. So there you can see the filters. Here, sorry, it's cut off a little bit. I'll move that over like there. And then, so what this is if the due date falls within this week, it will pop up. If it's the past week, or it's next week, they'll all filter into this section right here. And then one other thing I like to do here is go sort by due date, and then sort ascending. So that way, if we had something here that's the 22nd, it will pop on top right there. And then I also like to test whether it works. So let's choose a low or medium task that is within, let's call it next week. So I'm gonna stick with the YouTube theme and say I need to create a script. Call it YouTube. We'll put the due date for the 29th and medium, and then captured. It will disappear here and it should pop up there. And it's good, it doesn't pop up there, so we are doing it right. And then we'll move on to our next category, which is sometime. All right, so here we have the exact same database because we just created another linked view. So everything's exactly the same. And to distinguish between the tasks we need to do this week and our task to do sometime in the future, we need to change the dates. So this is a little bit confusing, but remember here that the dates are this week, next week, and then the past week. So if a task was a super long time from now, it will be in this section, and then once the date approaches, it will move into this. But say we forget a task and it's like 2 weeks have gone by and we never did it, and so it would leave this week's section, but we'll actually put up date parameters that will make it move back to the sometime list. So basically, think about it like this. You have 2 months from now, a task that you want to get done. You just, something you thought of, you put it into the brain dump and it goes into the sometime section. And then as the time approaches, it moves into this week's section. And then we completely forget about it, and the due date passes, and it's over a week old, it will move back down to the sometime section. I created this just so I wouldn't forget a task. Like say, I don't know, we were really bad and we let it go 3 weeks through the this week's section and we never did it. So I didn't want it to just like disappear off of this list. So it moves back to the sometime section. So I'll show the dates that you want to have so you can see what to do. All right, so those are the correct things you should have there. So that way nothing is missed between this week and the sometime section. Your medium and in a low task priority. The other thing you want to do is because in this we'll have low and medium tasks, we actually need to add another sort, and we're going to sort by priority. So we'll actually sort and we'll put it like this, so it'll actually sort priority for first and then due date. That way medium is on top of low and then it goes by due date. So that is everything you need there, and then let's test it real quick. Let's go up to our brain dump section. Take thumbnail pictures with money or something like that. Stay in the YouTube theme, go here, and then let's say we need to do this really far out. So let's go August 31st. We'll call it a medium priority and then we'll capture it. And then it should pop up here, which is exactly what we want. Everything else should be good here. And then as the time moves closer, it will move to this week's section. And then if we needed to move it to the higher priority section, we can just drag it from there to there. And then the last thing we want to do is create our done section. So what we'll do is create another call out. Copy link, put it here, create linked view of database. And then, so we don't need that many filters. We can leave that sorted, that's fine. We don't need due dates anymore, we'll delete that. And we don't need to sort by that. Delete, and then done is checked. So now when we've completed something, say we created this thumbnail, completed it, it will go here. And then that way we can see the tasks that we accomplished. Okay, so my special gift to all of you is that in the description of this video, there's a link that goes to a free template that all of you can download and copy into your Notion. I didn't want to give it to you right at the beginning because I wanted you to understand and see the valuable tool of linked databases and also know how to use the filters and the different sorting features. But I also didn't want you guys to get stuck trying to make it on your own, so I went ahead and gave you that template, and it's also just a reward for making it to the end of the video. But I think that this system will be super helpful to you, especially if you've never used any type of task management system before. So just thank you for following along with the tutorial, and I'll see you guys in the next one.